traditionally we've relied a lot on ships like this one, and there's still many measurements that we need to make that we can only make from a ship. And so it's a great tool, but it's also expensive and slow. So this trip that we're on now, it's a little bit like driving from Sydney to Perth at 20 k's an hour, and every 3 hours you have to stop for 3 hours. So it takes you a long time to get anywhere. So it's slow and it's expensive, and so there's a limit to how much of the ocean we can cover with if we only rely on ships. So over the last 5 or 7 years, we've started to develop tools that are really transforming how we do our work out here. One of those are Argo profiling floats. These are small cylinders that measure temperature and salinity as a function of depth in the ocean. We toss those over the side and they can change the buoyancy so they can either float or sink. And they drift with the ocean currents about a kilometer below the surface. And every 10 days they pop up to the surface, measure temperature and salinity as they rise, send that data back to us by satellite. And there are about 3,000 of those floats now around the world ocean. And in a real sense, it's the first time we're measuring the ocean beneath the sea surface. And in particular in places like the Southern Ocean, where shipping has always been scarce because it's a horrible place to be in a ship most of the time. So it's the strongest winds and the biggest waves anywhere you can find in the ocean. And there's very little merchant shipping down here. So we've always suffered from a lack of data in the Southern Ocean. These floats are allowing us to really measure the ocean for the first time in remote regions like this. And the third big one is satellites. So about 20 years ago, we started launching satellites that can measure a whole variety of properties of the ocean from space. The most powerful one for us as physical oceanographers who study ocean currents are satellite altimeters that can measure the height of the sea surface to within a few millimeters. And this is the height of the surface if you smoothed out all the waves. And so when wherever there's an ocean current in the ocean, there's also a slope to the sea surface. So the sea surface sits about a meter and a half higher south of Tasmania than it does against the coast of Antarctica. And we can measure that, those slopes of the sea surface, really precisely with satellite measurements now. And that combination of satellites looking down from above and Argo floats profiling from below is really transformed how we do our work in the last 5 or 7 years.